You look really 90s right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, no problem.
What's
up? The 90s don't stop with you.
No, they don't. Welcome to the latest episode of Chaps Cast Game Chat.
Yep.
Episode 34, I believe.
34.
Yeah, sounds good. I'm one of your hosts, Josh Dunkley, joined by the amazing Steve Winterman.
If it wasn't 34, it is now. That's the important thing.
Yes.
Yeah. So watch out for episode 50. It's going to be a doozy.
Fuck, now we got to do something for 50.
Oh, we got stuff planned for 50.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We do.
For sure, Steve.
It's going to be great.
Well, Steve.
Yes.
Before we start into anything, video games, any topics, anything, what do we have to do?
We have to do a shot of the show.
Now, Steve.
I'm going 6 months without a shot of the show. That means I'm going to owe, like, what, 24 shots. Uh-huh.
So we're going to film you taking 24 shots?
See, it won't be able to be done in one sitting. Like, I'm pretty sure someone would die.
No, I'm
pretty sure someone... That's like a liter of whatever booze.
I believe in you, Steve.
No, I don't. Not at that point.
All right, Steve. All right. What... You gave me a random surprise shot today.
Yes.
Next week, are we going to do special shots? We should do special shots.
Special shots of what?
Oh, something you can do.
I'm enjoying this, not having to do it.
I'm a lonely drinker.
It's been refreshing.
All right. Well, I guess I'll cheers myself out of the mic.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, now I kind of feel like a dick.
Cheers, camera. And by the person watching, maybe.
Yeah, pour yourself a shot of something.
Yeah, Tommy, don't leave me hanging.
Don't leave him hanging.
Like Steve did. Okay. Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
So weird.
I know. It's weird watching you take this. We got 6 months of this to go.
What was that?
Casket? Small body casket? I don't know. Dwarf casket? Something casket. Old casket. Maybe basket. Could be a basket. Could be some apples in a basket.
Mm.
I don't know.
Some green eggs and ham?
No. Now you're just being ridiculous. No. So, Josh, what are we talking about today?
Video games.
Talking about video games. What about video games?
Well, Steve, I just beat Final Fantasy.
Oh, you beat it?
I beat it.
Oh, how long did that take you?
I played it for about 60 hours.
Tell me about it.
It's a fantastic
game. Whoa, team. It took you 60 hours.
Yeah.
But wasn't there a boss that actually takes like 3 days to beat? Now, my understanding was that it was separated, but 3 days to beat?
I don't think so. I think there's... The largest one is after you beat the game, this huge mountain comes to life, and it's a giant turtle. And I heard people take like 3 to 4 hours to beat that.
No, because it was on Clueless Gamer, and they're like, this takes like 3 days, but like broken up in segments, they made it sound like.
Maybe? I don't know.
Huh.
I haven't come across this thing.
Okay.
I did a lot of grinding early on, where I went from like level 20 to level 43 in like...
Yeah?
Yeah. well, because like in that game, you gather experience and then you don't apply it until you sleep.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. I did, like, I think 200,000 experience.
In one sleep?
Yeah. Cool. And then, like, if you sleep at the right hotel, they can, like, double your experience that you earned.
Sorry, that part's kind of dumb.
It's pretty great.
All right.
Got up pretty high.
Okay, so...
The game was real easy after that.
What level did you get to by the end of the game?
I think I finished it around 59, 60.
Okay, and this was your first Final Fantasy game.
It was.
Tell me about it. What was your experience like?
I thought it was awesome. I love the characters.
Yeah. You like the boy band?
It's not really a boy band.
Kind of a boy band.
No.
Well, like, it doesn't have to be in a negative way. Like, everyone loves NSYNC.
It's, yeah. I don't know. It's really cool. I love the characters. See, because it's about Noctis, right? He's the prince.
And black-haired guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
One of the black-haired guys.
Oh, okay. Black-haired guy. I got you.
Yeah, the one that looks sad all the time. He's getting married.
Okay.
Don't know if that's a correlation.
Sure.
Yeah. So, and his royal bodyguards are escorting him on his trip to get married.
Oh, that's what they are.
Yeah.
Do they ever break out into song and dance?
No. Not that I've come across. You got Prompto. He's a blonde-haired guy. He takes lots of pictures, but he's real bad at taking pictures sometimes.
Okay.
Like he'll be in a battle and he'll just take a picture of a tree. It's like, Prompto, what the fuck are you doing?
It's a very important tree. It was crucial to the battle.
Yeah. And this goddamn Prompto.
So he would just stop, and I got to take a picture of this tree.
Well, like, you never see him take a picture, but it's like when you go to rest, you get to see all the pictures he took since the last time you guys rest.
Is he the only character that takes pictures?
Yeah.
Do they all have, like, unique characteristics like this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ignis, he is your main chauffeur.
Is he the one that doesn't wear a shirt?
No, that's Gladio.
We need to buy him a shirt.
Ah.
What? Gladio. Okay.
Well, Ignis, he's a chef.
Okay.
And, like, just randomly, or, like, he'll go to a restaurant or whatever, and he will, like, he'll eat a meal there, and he'll be like, I got a new recipe, guys. And he'll copy it, and it's like, I don't think you have a new recipe. I think you're stealing this. Or you'll defeat someone.
You cannot write a cookbook based around this.
Or you'll kill some wild animal and be like, oh, I have a new recipe, guys. Like, the shit?
Was it in his stomach? Did you just take parts of him? What? What? Wouldn't make a soup out of this.
It's pretty great. Gladio was good at surviving. I don't know what that means. He beat stuff up real good.
Okay. What do you mean? Like, he says he's real good at surviving?
Yeah, like, they each have their...
character doesn't die.
They have their... each their own little, like, this is what they're good at.
Oh, okay.
So, Prompto's photos, Ignis is cooking, Gladio's survival, and Noctis. Noctis is good at fishing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you actually get the fish?
Oh, yeah.
No, just checking. What's the gameplay like?
It's, third-person action.
Yeah. You said turd.
Turd person action. No, I don't know. It's pretty easy. You just hold the attack button, and it does attacks automatically, and then you can press the other button to dodge.
Is there any actual, like, strategy to it? Because most of the Final Fantasy games are, you take turns.
Yeah.
This seems more...
That's gone.
Kingdom Hearts, where it's just a matter of... You're just fighting, which is fine. I love Kingdom Hearts. But okay, so that's what it is now.
Yeah, just fighting. Each enemy has its own type of weaknesses, whether it's like pistols or if it's a sword or it's a great sword. So going into a battle where there's like three different kinds of enemies, you have to be like, okay, which one do I focus on first? Do I use? Which weapon do I use? And then your buddies, they all have their own special powers.
Yep.
So like... Prompto, he has one that's called the Gravity Sphere. It pulls all the enemies in close. So if you have a super effective weapon, use that. Go in, kick some ass.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, do you like this game more or less than what you expected?
I thought it was going to be an okay game, but I loved it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, because it was 2016, how do you feel like it compares to your other 2016 games?
I feel like it would be on my best of list. It'd take over
top five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take Overcooked off for sure.
Was it Overcooked number 5?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd probably put it number 4. I don't know. Like it gets in a hole for mole switching it around. But it'd be on there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So recommend to buy.
Absolutely. It's awesome. And it takes a lot of time.
Alright.
And in a good way, like not in a Witcher 3 way where it's gonna take you 200 hours.
Yeah.
But like yeah, that's awesome. But Final Fantasy beat it in like 60 hours.
That's still a lot of time, so.
It is. Yeah, it is. It's good. It's a good 60 hours. Like, I haven't gotten to an RPG like that for a while, and that was what I needed.
Good.
Just chill out, like, listen to podcasts, kick some ass.
Oh, so you don't even have to listen to the story, really, or their subtitles?
Well, because, like, the main part where I was grinding, like, just doing random hunts and stuff, that's where I was just podcasts, kick some ass.
That's one thing I have I like that. It rhymes.
Yeah.
One thing I have a hard time doing with video games is listening to like a podcast or something and playing a game.
Yes.
Because I like to give whatever I'm doing in terms of that my full attention. I don't know why, but even if it's like the podcasts we watch, like there's YouTube series and stuff where that's all I'm doing. Maybe I'll be eating too, but as Greg knows, even when I'm eating, I'm not paying full attention to the show. Me and Greg had a hard time with that when we were roommates. I have a hard time with that anyways.
What do you eat when you're playing games?
Well, like, it could be anything. Like, you could just be...
Anything.
Fuck off. You know what I mean? No, just like snacking away or something. But or I wasn't even eating while playing games. I was like eating while watching a movie or watching a show or something. Because we'd watch a lot of, like, Daily Planet. And we'd be having dinner for Daily Planet because it was only at 7 o'clock. And we'd sit there, watch it, and then Greg would be like, oh, that's so cool. I was like, no idea what you're talking about. I'm focused on this. Getting it to my mouth and stuff.
Anything can happen there.
Anything can happen during that time. So yeah, I have a hard time listening to podcasts while gaming. Even Stardew Valley, I was not.
Really?
Yeah.
That seems like a...
Very for, I imagine, most people. I just don't like to.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Anyways, anything else you're playing?
Playing right now, I played the new Ruby game, Grim Eclipse.
Okay, I don't know what's that.
It's based on the anime, Ruby by Rooster Teeth.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Just an open world. Well, it's not an open world. It's a third-person action game as well.
I feel like this should be on Xbox, but I have a feeling it's on PlayStation.
It's on both.
Oh, is it? Yeah. Okay. Are you playing it on PlayStation now?
I am, because it came bundled with the DLC, which has some of my favorite characters, so I was like...
Yeah. Okay.
But it's all characters from the show. The only problem is there's no real, like, story to this, and there's no... Like, there's no cutscenes. It's just, like, person talking over radio to you, and then your character will randomly say something back. And it's...
Is it, like, fetch quests?
It's, no.
I sincerely have no idea what this is about.
It's a linear game, a linear action game.
Okay.
You just go around. I don't even know the story of it, to tell you the truth.
I feel like this is almost like a... Is it very repetitive? I feel like
it is very repetitive.
Okay, so I feel like this is literally like Neverwinter, where it's like, hey, you go talk to this guy, you go kill these things, you report back.
Not even. It's not open world. It's level. Like, you do one level, so you're going straight through, enemies will spawn, you attack them, and be like, hey, there's this thing, you have to defend it. So waves of enemies come at you.
Okay.
And I was playing single player. It's designed to be a online, like, slasher game.
Yeah.
Don't think open world, like, think Warriors or, like, Dynasty Warriors. Cool. It's kind of like that.
Okay.
That is a very good way to describe it. So, if you like mindless, just...
Hack and slash,
that's pretty much this game.
Yeah. Which is fine.
Yeah, it's fine. It's not... See, because it was made with, like, Rooster Teeth, you'd think they probably put so much love into the story or the characters.
Yeah. But no.
But no, it's... I don't know. Cool. Nothing special.
Fair enough. Anything else you're playing?
I'm playing a game which you have played.
Yes.
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Yeah.
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
That's what we should do. It's fun.
It's a good game.
Yeah.
Just a side-scroller, beat 'em up.
Yep, very straightforward.
What do you think of it, Steve?
We have tons of time. Yeah, very straightforward. I don't know how far you got in it.
I beat it.
Oh, okay. I haven't beaten it yet. Because I don't want to beat it without playing it with Greg, because that's what we started doing.
Mm.
So I'm on like there's six main stages? Yeah. So I think we're on the fifth.
Okay, Yeah.
So what I did was I was playing as the Black Ranger first. I got unlocked Tommy, the Green Ranger, and then, Greg and I unlocked him. Then Greg left. And I decided to play as the Green Ranger by myself on single player, up until about the same part. Although I discovered leveling up on single player, sorry, I have like a burp coming up. I've been trying to hold back for a bit. So I discovered when leveling up on single player, it levels up much slower, it feels like, in comparison.
Hmm.
Like, it was really disappointing. Like, I was level 2 by the time I was almost level 4 multiplayer.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I was sitting, like, I was like, this is dumb, and I feel like if I was playing single player, like, it wouldn't faze me. But I was like, my other character is much stronger than this at this point. I don't get it. But then again, also, like, enemies in relation to it, I'm sure, change too, in terms of co-op and stuff. So, I don't know. That kind of bugged me, though. Besides that, though, it's a lot of fun. Very straightforward. Very basic, but not in a bad way.
Yeah,
like
I agree.
I like the art style.
Yeah, it's good.
The boss battles, in terms of the Megazord, and what you're fighting, those are painfully repetitive.
What did you think of them? Like, so, did you like those?
First, you sit there and you press. I don't remember if it's A or X, and you have to tap that while aiming at the little crosshairs.
Yeah.
So you do that, very easy, and then you have to press the buttons as fast as you can to get through the section. When you're actually, like, using your sword and stuff, right?
Yeah, like, a quick time button. But A, Y, B, B.
That part I liked, because I like doing the timed events type stuff.
Yeah.
But the previous part just got painfully repetitive, and I was like, oh, what do you fucking do?
He's gonna shoot two balls of things at me.
And I have to shoot away those balls. Like, what do you do? That's really my biggest issue with it, was those boss battles sucked. Now, the ones always I don't know if it's always prior because I haven't beat it yet, but the ones mostly prior to that were fun for the most part.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know about you, but were you using the D-pad or the analog?
D-pad, for sure.
Okay. Because usually I ask and you're like, oh no, use the analog stick.
Because the analog stick, for a lot of games that we've talked about, I think is much better. With the exception of, now even, I was going to say the exception of Shovel Knight, because I've come around to it on Shovel Knight, use both. But even that, I can use either one, so I'm fine.
I go both ways.
Yeah. But even on that, I don't know which one I prefer. It's that I just adjusted to using the D-pad as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I don't know. That one's super D-pad, though, because the analog stick sucks ass.
Does it?
Yeah, it's awful.
See, I didn't even try the analog stick.
Good choice.
But I noticed with the dash, like you have a dash attack, a forward dash attack.
Yes.
I noticed several times I'd push right on the D-pad twice and then my attack, but he wouldn't sprint and do the attack. He would just walk forward and do like a basic attack. And it's like, no, this enemy requires me to dash. Why aren't you dashing when I double click the... And it was just getting annoying.
Yeah. Who did you play as?
Red.
Okay. Ranger. Cool.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts?
I thought it was a good game.
Yeah. That's it. All right.
No, it's your basic side-scrolling beat-em-up.
I'd say it's worth $15.
15?
Yeah. I was disappointed that it didn't have online co-op because I thought that would make it much better, obviously, making it connect with people so much easier.
Mm-hmm.
But I also kind of appreciated that it was couch co-op, because right now, like, sure, I want to play it. I'm not going to, though, because I'll send Greg a text later and we'll hang out and play.
Yeah.
Because we haven't sat down and actually played a game in a long time. So, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know about you, but when I was playing single player, I had a problem where, like, it would just lag a bit.
I didn't notice it.
No? No, yeah, I had it skip some frames and like freeze on me for a little bit.
Hmm.
Like, not like super annoying because it's pretty forgiving.
Yeah.
Especially when you're playing single player, there's a lot of health because.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I don't know. It's a good game. I enjoyed playing it. I got most of the achievements you can get doing single player.
They're super easy achievements.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. That's
pretty good.
Pretty much it. I'm playing Titanfall.
Oh, Steve. What do you think about Titanfall so far?
We might as well use this for the rest of Titanfall then.
You want to do some Titanfall?
Do you want to finish talking about Titanfall? Because we got 10 more minutes.
Titanfall.
Or do you want to do a whole episode based on Titanfall?
I feel like it's going to get pretty cluttered in the next coming months. Topics.
So we'll toss out Titanfall.
Okay.
A lot of fun.
Yeah?
The single player, that's what I'm playing right now. I think about 2 levels left. Maybe 3, okay. I think 2. So I was trying to get all of the helmets.
Ooh.
And so I had an online guide going through it. Because they're very easy. It's just I don't want to go out of my way every time to search down every nook and cranny of this. And I was like, they're very straightforward. Just a matter of knowing where to look.
Yeah.
So I was doing that. And that's really what's kind of deterred me from finishing it so far.
Really?
Yeah, because like finding them's not fun. But I already got so far in it. Like I know I have to now.
Well, you know, like, you can always go back to, like, chapter select.
Yeah, and I totally missed 1 or 2. Like, I missed the odd thing. Like, I think I only missed 2 so far.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was like, fuck, I don't want to go all the way back to do this. But, like, hunting that stuff down, some games are fun. I don't find this one that fun to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So, but the gameplay's great. Boss battles are kind of dumb in that they're one-offs. Like, there's no story. There's just... Here's this boss in this level.
I'm going to talk smack through to you through the whole level and then...
Yeah, and then be a 2-minute fight. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Achievements are relatively easy for the most part. That's it, really. Like, it's a fun game. There's something about Titanfall that gets me that Battlefield and Call of Duty don't.
Hmm.
I don't know if it's actually the Titans themselves that I find a lot of fun, but there's something about Titanfall games that get me.
That's...
Yeah,
so, like, you still haven't gone back to Call of Duty at all?
Not yet. To be fair, like, I'm still playing other stuff, but I got to go back to it eventually. You just lent me so much. I need to pound something out.
Just pound it out.
Pound it out. Yeah.
Going raw.
Raw dog. Yeah. That's my Titan's name.
Oh.
Raw dog.
You like riding?
Maybe. What's it to you? A jealous laugh.
I'm excited to see what you think of, like, a couple of the last levels.
Okay.
There's one, like...
Or just be Beacon, I think.
Beacon. I don't remember.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, that's the problem. The bosses weren't very memorable.
Yeah.
Even though they...
Some of them have, like, unique qualities.
Yeah.
Sure. But, like, there's nothing great about the story. I'm literally just playing for the gameplay.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And the gameplay in that game is fantastic.
Yeah. Oh,
I went to the trouble of 100%ing it because I liked it so much. And, Steve is so great.
I considered doing that.
Yeah.
And then I played, like, two or three levels on, is it Master?
Yeah.
And then I was like, nope, I died, like, three or four times on one spot. I was like, I'm going to tone this down. I don't care that much.
That's right.
Whatever. And then if I was still doing it on Master, man, I would be further behind now, so.
See, playing it through on normal first, you learn what you can do to make it easier for you on Master.
Yeah.
And how you can kind of skip enemies.
Oh, yeah, because you played through twice.
Yeah.
Oh, man, Steve. Good game.
It's a really good game. In the last chapter, I'm going to say. Well, you got to the one part. Kind of spoilery. You did, right?
I don't know. Tell me more.
You get this thing that lets you switch between past and future.
Yes, that's dope as fuck.
Right?
Yeah, that was cool. And then a lot of times you would have to, like, run up on the walls, switching between them to get around things and get around enemies that might not exist in the other one. Yeah, that was cool. I liked it. Big fan. that was a while ago, so. Yeah. Sleep.
Oh, man. Now,
What are you trying to say?
I was going to ask why you were going for the helmets right away. Like, is it because I told you 100% of it beforehand? And then you're like, I should do these while I'm at it?
It was one of those, like, I don't think I'm going to play it twice.
Mm.
So I'm going to go through this anyways.
Oh, okay.
So I might as well pick these up. And then after I saw, like, the first few, I was like, wow, these are super easy to get.
That's a great game, and I wish I had played it.
It's one I don't remember my top five games, but it might have made the fifth slot.
Yeah,
because I remember my top two: Overwatch and then Inside.
Good calls.
Third was Quantum Break. Quantum's gonna stay there.
Really, you thought that highly of Quantum?
I love Quantum Break. It was a great game. Yeah. I don't know if it was third or fourth now.
I think it was third.
Yeah. Yeah. Actually, that one I was considering for Game of the Year for a while.
Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah, anyways, we should probably wrap this up.
Wrap it up.
Yeah, Josh, you better be wrapping up. No. where should people be reaching us at, Josh?
At our email, of course, Steve.
Tell me, where's that?
ChapsPodcast@gmail.com.
All right, and if that's too hard, where can they reach us?
Facebook.com/ Chaps Cats
Podcast. I thought you were leaving just Facebook. Okay.
Yeah.
Good start. Make sure you like, subscribe, Facebook, Twitter, not Twitter, YouTube.
YouTube. iTunes.
iTunes.
Give us a good review.
Yeah. Touch bases.
Leave a little review. Yeah.
Write a little bit.
Play Titanfall 2 and Final Fantasy because those are awesome.
Yeah.
Those are great games. Steve, okay, when you beat it, you have to tell me what you think of the last level.
Is it really good?
It is a really good segment.
Huh.
Yeah. Like, you know how you felt going back, like, between past and present?
Yeah.
It'll be like that.
I think I just beat the level where your Titan, I don't remember his name offhand, BT or something, whatever, throws you. He's throwing you across this massive gap onto, like, these little floating, I think they're floating island type things. Ish. So there's like one, and then like they all connect, and you have to use like these cranes to try the walls.
Oh, yep. You have to get to the satellite relay and
set that back. I think that's the level I just beat, or I beat the one just after that, but maybe the one just after that just not memorable.
Like, that's fair.
Yeah. Anyways, tune in next time.
Yeah.
This goes up on
Monday.
Monday. Tune in on Friday for ChapsCast Podcast.
Yes.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.
Bye, everybody.
What's up? Man, I was trying to beat you to it. One day I'm going to beat you to it.
No, you're not.
Maybe I'll turn the gain off on this one day and then go for it.
I'll find a way.
One day.
I'll find a way. Bye, everybody.